arguably, but they have two of the better-looking bodies in all of pro wrestling.
Put Goldberg on the bus.
Well, good point made. You want to be in charge of the bus now, too?
I'm golfing, thank you.
Here he comes.
Ray the Giant Killer.
1 week ago tonight, the high watermark in this young man's career. And what a way to come back. Less than 24 hours after losing his mask, Rey Mysterio Jr. knocked off big sexy Kevin Nash last Monday on Nitro and beat him 1-2-3.
A different look, obviously. Not only the mask, but he's completely changed. He's got the jeans on now. Looks a little more hip. I like it. And I think he's a very fine-looking young man, and I know, and the world knows, what a competitor he is. Now, it's out of the frying pan into the proverbial fire here after a seven-footer like Big Sexy, arguably one of the quickest big men ever, a 300-pound beast from the East, over 300-pound beast from the East, Bam Bam Bigelow, living legend.
It's going to be interesting. Last week, the man was 7 foot tall. This week, the man is 7 foot wide. See if he can make it too. I know Bigelow likes to have that beast feast, but Rey Mysterio may just be an hors d'oeuvre.
Not only is Bam Bam one of the biggest and one of the quickest, but there's been a lot of talk within the ranks of WCW, especially from Bigelow, from the newcomer named Hack, who's been most impressive, and from the return of Raven about who is extreme, who is hardcore, who will do anything, use anything it takes to win a match. And Bigelow, cut from that mold, certainly not only is he big, he's very dangerous, Mike.
Well, it seems that those three men are out to prove something. Who is the king of hardcore? Between Raven, Hack, and Bam Bam Bigelow, I can't wait to see those three get it on.
Meanwhile, it's Bill City. He beat him all the way to Raleigh on that one.
Yeah, he threw Mysterio around like a piece of paper, and I'm surprised Bigelow's not all over him.
You know, I would agree with that. One would think that when you have Ray down and you have the definite size advantage, that you take advantage of it. But Bigelow walked in with a lot of confidence.
You know, you'd think that, but again, after what happened last week, Bigelow's got to be careful. You beat Kevin Nash, you know it's a possibility. And look at Ray go!
Spin kick rocked him, didn't take him off of his feet. Mysterio off the top. Oh, caught him in midair.
Knowledge.
6'5", 340, just landed right on the chest of Rey Mysterio Jr.
He lost his balance momentarily, and that's all Bigelow needed. But once again, this is not good wrestling against a guy like Rey Jr.
I'll tell you what, it could be overconfidence. Bigelow may be thinking Rey's easy pickings here. I don't know.
Way up. Look at Rey. Rey's helpless. He's alert up there, you can tell. Looking around, not knowing what Bigelow's going to do next.
All he knows is gravity is his enemy right now.
Trying to find a place to land. Gorilla press. Where's he going to toss him?
He tossed him over the head of Doug Dillinger and onto the other security guards around the ring area.
He threw him 10 or 12 feet up the aisle. Up and over the top rope.
Bigelow's got to feel confident. He knows Ray's out. That's a nasty thing to do right there.
That's a confident smirk on the face of Bam Bam Bigelow. He knows he had Rey Mysterio Jr. down for the three count, but he's out to dish out more pain and punishment, just like that scoop and a body slam.
There he goes again.
I tell you, you know how Bigelow would feel, how Nash has got to feel being beat by a little man like this. Bigelow does not want that to happen to him.
Airborne, raise up quickly now. He climbs to the top. Turnbuckle! Couldn't get him off his feet.
He just don't have the weight.
But he went to the knees again. Oh! Tried to use Bam Bam as a springboard, but slipped, but he still is up on top. Head first. He's going to cover. One, two,
no!
Oh, what a match.
Oh, man! Oh.
And down goes Ray.
Dead!
And we begin the second hour of WCW Monday Night Raw. And the Mean Dome has the Bigelow almost demanding that Ray get back to his feet. And why, Ray can barely pull up here, Mike.
Why doesn't he just put him away, take him out of his misery at this point?
I can tell you why. One of the reasons would be bragging rights.
Well, not only that, Bigelow's a nasty guy. I mean, he enjoys hurting people.
I mean, if Bigelow can not only beat Ray, but destroy Ray a week after Ray pulls the giant killing upset over Big Sexy, then he would have certainly have some bragging rights around the world of pro wrestling. Into the ropes again.
Oh, Mysterio fell out of the corner. Fortunately for him, he caught Bigelow low, now climbs up on top. Ride him, Ray!
Rolls him up! One, two, three!
The giant killer lives!
Look at that face! You think he's not ready to fight some more?
The failure of Bam Bam Bigelow to put Ray Jr. away cost him in the end.
A giant Ray used Bigelow's own weight against him. If I had a hat, I'd take it off for Ray.
Let's remember that last week when Big Sexy had him up for that jackknife, he pounded on the head, leading to the win. And that's kind of what led him to the win this week, Larry. First of all, let's go back 1 week ago and see what happened.
Well, that was Nash right there again. Kevin Nash could have been a victim of overconfidence and underestimation of a man the size of Ray Jr. He just didn't even think that Ray would be. It never entered his mind until it was too late. And I'm sure Bam Bam Bigelow isn't going to forget himself. He had an opportunity to pin Ray, didn't do it, and it came back to haunt him. Watch this. Bam Bam's not familiar with this, but look at how Ray held on to that leg. The big man couldn't get out. His own weight was turned against him.
Off and running on TNT from another angle now. Once again up top, pounding on the head. Remember, he fell forward that time, but this time spun around to roll him up. Another sensational win by the giant killer, Ray Jr. Ric Flair's arrival is imminent. We're going to be hearing from him later on in this telecast. Plus Goldberg and Rick Steiner against Scott Steiner and Buff Bagwell in our tag team feature coming up tonight on WCW Monday Night Raw.
See, this goes to prove it's the beauty of science that defeats the beast.
Never thought he could do it 2 weeks in a row and over two huge names like Big Sexy Kevin Nash and now Bam Bam Bigelow.
All right, fans, as we said, any moment now we are awaiting the arrival of the Nature Boy, Ric Flair. And right now, though, we're going to take you to Mean Gene Okerlund.
All right, I am back in the locker room area. I wanted to bring this young man in. Ray, before you head for your locker room tonight, big win over Bam Bam Bigelow. A week ago tonight in Sacramento, it was Kevin Nash. Maybe this mask coming off has been kind of a blessing in disguise.
You know what, Gene? I thank the Lord, because with me, with my size, I'm just representing for all those small people out there think they can't do anything in life.
Lex Luger, please. This
What's
is
up
not
with this in the shirt, man? I forgave. I forgave, Ray.
I heard you.
What's up?
I heard you.
What's up with that, huh?
It's not me, man.
Oh, hey! Oh! What in the world?
Oh! Should have took the shirt, Ray.
Stop the
you
insanity!
You had your chance, Ray.
Should have took the shirt, Ray.
You had your chance of a lifetime. You blew it.
Could have had the shirt.
Right, took the shirt, Ray.
Give him a wedgie.
Hey, come on, Nash.
Give him a wedgie.
Absolute animals back there. Please, get somebody in here. This is becoming absolutely ridiculous. Good Lord.